So that's it for Unit 8 in an Introduction to Agent-Based Modeling, where we kind of took you through a couple of vignettes related to the history of agent-based modeling. Now, I want to just reiterate what I said at the very beginning. This is one particular take on different factors that influence agent-based modeling. There are definitely some elements that we've left out of this story that if you're really interested, I highly recommend you look into. Probably most notably, the history of individual-based modeling from the ecological systems, right, literature. The more recent work on artificial life. You know, most of the stories that we've told here kind of end about the time that agent-based modeling starts to take off, late 90s, early 2000s. But there's actually been history since then, obviously, and so looking into some of that would be interesting as well. Just as a quick wrap up, to remind you that we've talked about the things like cellular automata and kind of its effect on building up this idea that you have these concrete rules and they interact with each other. We've talked about genetic algorithms and adaptive agents, right? This idea that agents don't have to take the same actions given past history that they've seen, right? And we've talked about logo and its direct impact on NetLogo, but also on, in general, on the idea of syntactic body reasoning and the idea that you can think of yourself as an agent when you build an agent-based modeling and a agent-based model that helps you to build the model and to understand a model that someone else has built for you, right? Object-oriented programming and all the notions that about encapsulating methods and data within a single class or object of an entity. Of course, parallelism and the idea that you could have multiple agents moving simultaneously. Particle systems, right, where you had this first notion, so this idea that you can simulate the many different actions, and then by looking at their emergent properties of how they interact, you see something different than you see when you look at one individual entity. So there's a rich history here. It's not a linear history. It's a non-linear interacting web of stories that come together to create a lot of the stuff that we talk about when we talk about agent-based modeling. I hope you've enjoyed this kind of brief tour, and that you kind of understand a little bit more about some of the places that agent-based modeling comes out of. Thanks.